So I have this Eaton UPS that looked like it had died. At some point I turned it off when it was impossible to turn it back on. It had the little green light on, which said that current was coming in. Surge Protect was probably working, but pressing this button, even for a long period of time, would not turn it on, would not do anything. It was completely dead. One thing I tried was to reset the breaker surge protector here, but didn't seem to do anything. So, but actually it turns out that the only thing I needed to do was to replace the batteries. And after replacing the batteries, can I turn it on? Yes, I can. Can I unplug it and will it continue to deliver current? Yes, it does. So what I did is I actually opened it up. You have to remove four screws here. One of the screws is a regular Phillips screw. The other ones are Torx screws. You need a special screwdriver like this one. And in this case, in order to be able to go all the way into the hole and get the screws, I needed a pretty thin one. So for that, I used the fixit kit with a lot of bits, including the one I needed. So once you remove this, you get to the circuit board. Here I have already replaced the batteries, but what I wanted to say is this part here, it's high voltage, high current. Don't touch it. Be very careful about not touching it. Theoretically, what we're doing here, it should be done by qualified electricians. So if you don't feel like you're a qualified electrician, don't do it. The old batteries I have right here, this was the reference I had. And those batteries are basically dead. If I measure the voltage, as you can see, this one has a negative voltage. And the other one had 0.49 volts. So the nominal voltage you should have on these batteries is 13.5 volts, which the new ones have. The new batteries were pretty cheap on Amazon compared to the whole UPS unit. It's about 20 euros or $20 per battery. So when you buy replacement batteries, you have to look to get the correct size, correct nominal voltage of 12 volts, correct capacity, in this case 7.2 ampere hours. And the other thing you have to look for is the width of the connectors here. So I show you on the old ones. For these ones, they were 6 point something millimeters. So with all that, you can replace the batteries. When you take it apart, take some photos of the cable path so it's easier to know how to reconnect it. Also be careful when you re-plug this back in, you will get a little electrical spark inside of the connector, which will make some noise. It's a bit scary. Be warned that it will happen, but it should be inside the connector. This is why you have this fat connector. And once you have done this, the new batteries will actually be able to turn it back on. Okay, maybe I have to press a little bit longer. See, now it's actually working on battery power. And I do a long press to turn it off. And once this is done, of course, you have to screw the panel back on. For now, I'm going to let it load for several hours before actually draining too much on the batteries. I don't know how loaded or not the batteries are when you receive them from Amazon. Okay, let it load. And don't forget, please like the video if it saved you from throwing away your whole UPS. And the other thing not to forget, please don't throw your batteries into the trash. They contain lead. It's very toxic for the environment. Please bring them to the recycling center. Thank you.